When we talk about the Hogwarts staff, it comes to mind Professor McGonagall, Lockhart, Snape and Flitwick. But there are some members who are really underrated and we don't know a lot about their lives, as they are most of the time kept in the shadow. In today's video, we'll be discussing these three professors' lives: Pomona Sprout, Madame Hooch and Poppy Pomfrey, what Hogwarts house they were in, their story in the series, and also what happened to them after the war. So let's get into it. Starting first with Poppy Pomfrey. Surprisingly, there is no record that Pomfrey actually attended Hogwarts, but I'm assuming based off her patient's determined loyal personality that if she did, she'd be a Hufflepuff. However, I could be wrong. Madame Pomfrey began her career at Hogwarts sometime before 1971, being trusted in that year by Headmaster Albus Dumbledore to escort new Gryffindor student Remus Lupin, who was infected with lycanthropy, to the Whomping Willow every full moon. Pomfrey was a very competent healer, having been in the position for a long time, taking care of the patients while in the hospital wing. In 1991, Pomfrey was the one who fixed Neville Longbottom's broken arm after he had injured himself during flying class, and Ron's dragon bites, and Harry after he fought Professor Quirrell and spent 3 days unconscious in the hospital wing under her care. Pomfrey was also taking care of Quidditch players whenever they get injuries while playing. Next year, Hogwarts was facing potential closure as a monster had been attacking Muggle-born students around the school and petrifying them as a result. It was Madame Pomfrey's job to make sure that these students were found and treated to the best of her ability, though she could not cure students without Pomona Sprout Mandrake Draught, which took weeks to brew. She refused to allow any student to visit the victims in fear of the attacker returning to finish them. Pomfrey played a huge role in the following year. She had to take care of the students who were attacked by Dementors, Quidditch injuries once again, and also the trio following the events that took place at the end of the year. During the next year, it was Madame Pomfrey's job to tend to the injuries that the four Triwizard champions received during the course of the tournament. Madame Pomfrey was also present at the end of the year when the Minister of Magic, Corlinius Fudge, visited the wing. The Minister refused to believe that Voldemort returned. Snape did reveal his dark mark as proof. Next year, it was again just a typical day for Pomfrey in the hospital wing, treating and taking care of injuries to students. In the 1996 school year, however, Pomfrey had a big challenge ahead. She examined Katie Bell after she had been cursed by an opal necklace. She couldn't help her and transferred her to San Mancus Hospital for Magical Maladies and Injuries for better treatment. She also tended to Ron after he had almost been poisoned after drinking a glass of mead, which had been done by Draco Malfoy in an attempt to kill Dumbledore. She also treated Draco after he was struck by Harry's Sectum Sempra curse. Later that year, Madame Pomfrey tended to the wounds and injuries of those who participated in the Battle of Astronomy Tower, including Bill Weasley, who was injured the worst of all. Madame Pomfrey was one of the hundreds of witches and wizards who attended the funeral of Albus Dumbledore. During the funeral, she was devastated by his death, being brought to tears after Harry told her that Dumbledore met his death at the hands of Snape. Pomfrey participated in the Battle of Hogwarts with no doubt, doing what she really good at, and she survived the war unharmed. By 2014, Madame Pomfrey had retired, or was thinking of retiring, since Hannah Abbott reportedly applied for the position of matron at Hogwarts. Madame Hooch. Rolanda Hooch was born before 1918. She taught herself to fly on a silver arrow broomstick at some point. She attended Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry in her youth and was a member of her house Quidditch team. However, it is unknown which Hogwarts house she was sorted into, but if you allow me to guess, I'd say Ravenclaw for many reasons. Sometime before her student years at Hogwarts, Rolanda was selected by the Department of Magical Games and Sports as the Hogwarts Quidditch referee. Rolanda's duties at Hogwarts included first year flight instructor, Quidditch referee, and coach in charge of all broom-related activities. She was now referred to as Madame Hooch and was respected by her students because of her liking for fair play and clean games. She was given an office located somewhere in the castle, in which the crate which held the golden snitches, Quaffle, and Bludgers was kept safe under lock and key when not in use. In 1991, Hooch had her first flying lesson to the new students students, including the famous Harry Potter. The rest of the year was just ordinary. She kept doing her duty, including refereeing the Quidditch matches. Next year, Hooch went to Diagon Alley and rushed to Flourish and Blood to see Gilderoy Lockhart. She was clearly a fan of him and of his written works. Next year, Madame Hooch refereed an unusual match of the Gryffindor versus Hufflepuff, which took place in severe weather conditions and poor visibility. But during the match, the matrons who were supposed to be guarding the school interfered and made Harry fall off his broomstick, enabling the Hufflepuff seeker Cedric Diggory to catch the golden snitch. Harry mysteriously received a Firebolt broomstick for Christmas. In order to ensure that the broom was safe to ride, McGonagall handed it over to Madame Hooch to examine it. A few weeks later, once the broom's safety was ensured, the Firebolt was returned to Harry to use. The following academic terms were to be dedicated to the revival of the Triwizard Tournament, meaning that the 1994 Quidditch Cup was not to take place. This was also due to the fact that the Hogwarts Quidditch Stadium was to play host to the Enchanted Hedge Maze of the third test. Because of this, it is assumed that Madame Hooch's only duties that year was to give flying lessons to the first year students, though she might have helped prepare the test with the other teachers. Next year, Madame Hooch's timetable for Quidditch matches was disrupted by Dolores Umbridge. Since she kept giving detentions to students who play the sport, it is possible that Madame Hooch had her flying lessons inspected by Dolores Umbridge that year and pleased her as she was not sacked. Near the end of the next year, the castle was invaded by Death Eaters who fought the teachers and students of Hogwarts. It is unknown whether Madame Hooch took part in the battle, but after the battle conclusion, Albus Dumbledore was found dead in the middle courtyard, and everyone around raised their wands as a sign of respect on him. It can be assumed that Hooch attended the Dumbledore's funeral, being a long-term colleague of him. In the next year, things changed completely, but Madame Hooch was probably more than likely to still doing her duties being a teacher at Hogwarts. She was also most likely there when Harry defeated and killed Voldemort for the good in the Battle of Hogwarts and in the Second Wizarding War. The Hogwarts Quidditch pitch was burned to the ground at the early stage of the battle. Madame Hooch survived the war and continued to serve as the flying instructor and Quidditch referee at Hogwarts School. Madame Hooch was still teaching as of 2020, at the age of at least 102. In September 2017, she taught Albus Potter and was not impressed with him as he struggled to make his broom rise. Pomona Sprout. Pomona Sprout was born into a wizarding family of unknown degree. Pomona was sorted into Hufflepuff House upon her arrival at Hogwarts and excelled at Herbology, and likely achieved a high-graded OWL in the subject. Pomona and Minerva McGonagall's student time at Hogwarts overlapped by 2 years. The two students enjoyed an excellent relationship both then and in later years. They also helped each other learn the subject they eventually taught. At some point after her graduation, Sprout returned to Hogwarts as a member of the Herbology department. She taught her classes in the greenhouses at the back of the castle and used one of the greenhouses as an office. Professor Sprout became head of the department and head of Hufflepuff House. Professor Sprout used to bring the most interesting stuff from the Herbology greenhouses to decorate the Hufflepuff basement. This was one of the reasons why Hufflepuffs were often very good in her subject. Sprout was Nefedora Tonks' head of house in the late 1980s. Sprout didn't make her a prefect in her 5th year due to her inability to behave herself. Professor Sprout was still teaching at Hogwarts by the 1991 school year. Albus Dumbledore trusted her to contribute to the defenses of the Philosopher's Stone Chambers. Sprout, being the herbology professor, possessed considerable knowledge of plants and thus planted a large amount of devil's snare in her chamber. That year, Sprout met the famous Harry Potter, who was among the first years she taught. She was also present at the end of the term feast, where Slytherin lost the house cup to Gryffindor, and in their 7-year winning streak. As the herbology teacher, Professor Sprout was in charge of fixing the damaged Whomping Willow branches after Harry and Ron drove a bewitched car into it. Sprout and her colleagues were understandably shocked by the opening of the Chamber of Secrets. After Mrs. Norris was found petrified, Professor Dumbledore decided that they were to use a mandrake drow to cure her. Professor Sprout was put in charge of this because that was what she does. By the end of the year, the mandrix had reached maturity and was completed for those who were petrified. At the end of the term feast, Professor Dumbledore and the rest of the school applauded Sprout for her contribution in the brewing of the mandrake drought. Next school year was just a typical year for Sprout, nothing special to mention, except Sirius Black's breaking into Hogwarts, which was something unusual. In the next year, Professor Sprout was the one who told Bartemius Crouch Jr. how good Neville Longbottom was at herbology. Moody then lent Harry some books on plants in order to indirectly help Harry with the second task of the Triwizard Tournament. Sprout seemed to act somewhat distant towards Harry throughout the school year, just because he was a second champion in the tournament from Hogwarts, and that she wanted Cedric Diggory, who was from her house, to be the only one to bring glory to Hogwarts. Sprout was so devastated about Cedric's death, she spoke with Amos Diggory and his wife, since she knew their son best as head of his house. She attended the memorial feast and believed Harry and Dumbledore's claims that Voldemort had returned. The following school year, Dolores Umbridge was made Professor of Defense Against the Dark Arts by the Ministry of Magic. Umbridge was despised by the majority of the staff, including Sprout. Sprout managed to show Professor Umbridge her teaching capability and avoided being sacked herself. She was later relieved to have Umbridge removed from the school and welcomed Professor Dumbledore back as headmaster. In the next year, Sprout helped the new potion master Hollow Slughorn in picking some potion herbs. Slughorn, however, proceeded to steal some venomous tentacula leaves while Sprout was not around. At the end of the year, the Battle of the Astronomy Tower took place with the Death Eaters invading Hogwarts. Professor Sprout likely participated, as did Minerva McGonagall, Phileas Flitwick, and Rubius Hagrid. After Dumbledore's death, Sprout met with fellow staff members to discuss the future of Hogwarts. She also supported the suggestion that Dumbledore should be laid to rest at Hogwarts, though no headmaster has ever received a burial there before. Sprout attended Dumbledore's funeral and led the Hufflepuffs down to the grounds where the ceremony was held. The next school year was a different year. The Ministry of Magic was taken over by Voldemort's Death Eaters. Severus Snape was made headmaster of Hogwarts, while his fellow Death Eaters teachers, despite the school now in the grasp of Voldemort, or perhaps because of it, Professor Sprout returned to the castle to teach and protect the students. One night, after being woken up by McGonagall's cat Patronus, Professor Sprout, still in her night clothes, went to find out what she wanted. They found Minerva McGonagall dueling Snape to death, and after being defeated, Snape then was chased by Flitwick and Sprout and McGonagall and flew out of the window, escaping them. She also witnessed the duel between Harry and Voldemort, which led to the latter's defeat. A celebrating feast was later held, but no one sat in their proper house tables. Pomona survived the war and harm, and she remained teaching at Hogwarts as herbology professor. By 2008, her former student Neville Longbottom had joined the herbology department and taught the subject alongside her. If you wanna see the 14 jobs in Harry Potter after Hogwarts, click on this video over here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon.